to Pimp a Butterfly, one of modern hip-hop's greatest albums of all time. This is modern hip-hop's greatest album. I need to spend these minutes talking to you about one of the greatest hip-hop and just all-around albums of all time. This album is able to go deep as much as possible, as long as still popping out bangers after bangers, man. It feels like Kendrick and the producers precisely made every song sound so unique. It is absolutely crazy. Now first, let's talk about Wesley's Theory, one of the greatest intros to an album of all time. The funky and whimsical beat of the jazz playing is so damn amazing, you'll just be transported into this world in the album. Next, For Free, which talks about the more economical issues in the world that are still clearly going on today, but it doesn't waterboard you into like liking it and forcing it into your ears, which clearly no one wants to hear that. It's boring and it's trash and it makes you want to go to sleep. Next, King Kunta, which is one of the more commercial successful songs, and it's such a bop. Next is These Walls, which is one of the more underrated tracks on the album. Just don't play the first minute in the car. I have definitely not done that before. Now let's take a break so far and let's talk about what's been happening after the songs. The poem. The poem keeps getting longer and longer, and it goes something like this. I remember you was conflicted, misusing your influences. Sometimes I did the same, abusing my power, full of resentment. Resentment that turned me into a deep depression. Found myself screaming in the hotel room. And then he keeps telling the poem as long and as long. And then at the end of the album, he reveals who he's talking to. And it's Drake. I mean, Tupac. Tupac. And how most people write off Kendrick as a guy who releases a verse every 30 years. And it's good. And this album put me more in touch with my black side as a light-skinned brethren. What am I even saying at this point? What the hell? Now to one of the more sadder songs, You. You is a real heartbreaking song because you realize it's Kendrick talking to a mirror about everything he's done wrong in his life, and it's basically really, really, really messed up. The second part of the song hits where it's just him in a drunken blaze talking about, and it always starts with the you the reason, and it really sucks. Like, it's a real emotional gut punch. But onto more lighter stuff is now the more commercial hit of the album, All Right, which is definitely the crowd's favorite, if you know what I'm saying. Like, it's one of his most popular songs of all time and plays it all the time at concerts, I know. And it's a little overplayed now, but at the same time, man, the song's amazing. The song's great. Now to kick off the second half of the album, For Sale, the interlude. It definitely transports you into this new world in the song, and it's a more lighter tone on this part of the album. Next, Mama, which is another one of the, it's not a lot to say about, it's just a very good song, produced very well. This is one of the more better and better produced songs on an album with amazing produced songs, man. It's crazy. Next is Hood Politics, which it is kind of funny how he says boo-boo a lot on the album, but other than that, it's still a great song. The beginning of the song, it makes you wish it was an actual real song and he didn't cut to the actual song, because the beginning of the song is awesome. Now one is another deep song, How Much a Dollar Cost, which I'm gonna give you the more abridged explanation to this. Kendrick takes a trip to Africa. He stumbles across a homeless man. The homeless man just asked for $1. He says no. Turns out that homeless man is God, and that $1 just costed him a new spot in heaven. And after that, Kendrick regrets himself for the rest of his life. It's one of those songs where you just have to listen to it, take my word for it. Complexion is up next, and What an Amazing Feature by Rhapsody is such a bop, man. Speaking of great features, up next, which is Institutionalized, Snoop Dogg appears, and it is a great feature. Two underrated picks of the album are definitely You Ain't Gotta Lie and I. Both are just so awesome, man. Like, you sleep on these bangers throughout the album, and banger after banger after banger, this album, man, is impeccable. And the last song that I talked about that closes the poem, Mortal Man, it's just one of those deep hidden songs, man. It's just a great conclusion to the greatest album of all time. And of course, he won the Grammy for this one. How do you not? And that's pretty much it. This really is my favorite album of all time, if I haven't said it enough. and I hope you guys listen to it. It is so great. It is so amazing, but listen to it. Please, peace out.